All right, so we're going to begin to make our digital mandala. And the first thing we're going to do is to create a new Google drawing. So I'm going to go to my file or Google Drawings. Everyone should be pretty familiar with this. Okay, and the first thing you want to do is you want to find the middle of your paper. So that's what we're going to use the ruler tools for. And if you use the ruler tool on one side of, to create kind of one side of the middle, the other side will automatically come in. And I'll show what I mean by that right now. So I'm going to take this ruler. And if you notice, my square is 10 by 10. So it's 10 inches long and then 10 inches wide. I'm just going to take the ruler and I'm just going to drag it over. I'm going to end at the 5. Okay, and as you can see, the vertical line showed up and the horizontal line showed up at the same time. So I'm all set with that. And now I know where I am in the middle of my workspace. And then I'm going to go to shapes and I'm going to start out with a really large circle. So I'm going to start here and pull it out pretty much all the way to the edges. And then I'm just going to go to here, lift it up until you're satisfied with your circle shape. Okay, this is a little oval and that's okay too, because as long as you're in, you know, the realm of something being round, then your mandala will be fine. Now, what I would recommend, so you're not getting kind of out of control in terms of color, is to create a list for yourself of three to four different colors that you'd want to type, that you'd want to have in your mandala. So I'm going to put that color scheme on the side. And this way I have that to remember. And I think that it's going to kind of make your design look a little bit more clear at the end, as opposed to kind of just randomly choosing colors and then you're not really following any particular color scheme. If you want to do a scheme like complementary colors, like we talked about earlier this year when we were doing elements and principles, you can do that. If you just have four colors that you really like that you want to choose, but I'd say three to four would be probably kind of the max that you want. Otherwise, the design can start to look really overwhelming and not very cohesive. So you just want to make sure that your design looks, you know, looks well put together. So I'm going to pick blue. I'm going to do the complement of orange. And I'm also going to include a neutral. So that would be like black, white, or gray. And I'm also going to include yellow because yellow and orange are relatively close together. And I'm just going to write that on, keep that on the side for myself there, just as kind of as a reminder. It's not going to show up in my final image. It's, you know, only I'm going to see that as I'm working. So that's just what I'm going to use to kind of remind myself of my color scheme. All right, so my circle is already blue, but this isn't really the blue I would choose. So I'm going to pick a little bit more interesting. Okay, and as long as your shapes are all going to be on your workspace, then this should all work out fine. Now you can pick a color for your background and you can do a gradient. You could just do a flat color. We've talked about gradients before. So I'm just going to pick a really pale yellow for my background. And now I'm still within my same, you know, color scheme here. All right. And now you are just going to start to add in your shapes. So this is now divided for yourself into four quadrants. And the way that I've been making my mandalas are if I do something in the first quadrant, I just copy it, and rotate it into the second, third, and fourth. So something like a shape. I'll pick something easy to start with. So kind of this teardrop shape. All right, so I have this here. I'm gonna kind of fit it right in between those lines. And then copy it. And then paste. And you just can spin it around. Slide it over so that they're all together on the line. And then the same thing, just paste again. Spin it around. And then paste again. So you're really only kind of inventing your design, and then I can change the color of this. You could also change the color first, and then you, when you're copying it and pasting it, the color's automatically, you know, changed for those. But I'm just gonna, that was the wrong shade. All right, and remember, you need to take two process photos while you're doing this. So just make sure that you download some images kind of as you're working, you know, before you finish up your final mandala. So this way you have your process pictures. There's shapes. You could also use the arrows if you want to. You can use some of these callouts if you want to, though those shapes are not as equal around all the sides. So they might be a little bit tricky to use. And then, of course, if you want to use any of the equations, you can use those too, like a plus sign here. So I'm going to put that. I'm going to change the color first. And then just copy it. Let's do something like that. You could do something in the middle too. Just bring that up. Oh. As you get more, as this becomes more involved, you just want to make sure that you're doing your clicking on the correct shape, which can be a little bit tricky, but. Remember, your backwards arrows will always reverse whatever mistake that you have. So you can always go back and to like your last step and then you know, proceed again. And if you're, triangle. I'm going to have this go across those lines. You can copy it. Okay, and then when you download this, I'm going to type this. it at all. So you could see, you could just really keep kind of going on and on and on and adding more and more shapes, and kind of, you know, making this more and more defined as you go. You want to at least have, you know, probably a dozen or so different shapes in your overall design that you're repeating, you know, either 2, 4, or 8 times, I'd say probably be the way that you want to go. And then use, you know, keeping in mind your color scheme that you've jotted down for yourself. So I'm going to download this as a JPEG just so you can see it. Okay, when you download it as a JPEG, you see your ruler lines are gone. So that is something that you don't have to worry about when you're, you know, submitting your final work. So this would be, you know, considered what I would do as my first process shot. And then I would keep adding to it, do another process shot, and then I would keep adding to it and then submit it for my final work.